Alright. I had a video request earlier for how to change these pads out on HVAC tapes. So I'm going to start with the Columbia's because they're the easiest ones to crack open. Somebody said that this Aerosmith tape didn't need a pad at all, which I actually didn't even notice that. So these are quite simple. Just pop a screwdriver in three holes here. And pry open on the tab, like so. One in the back here. And one in the back here. Now, this is already at the splice. Splice looks fine on it. Get these off A-Track Heaven or eBay, wherever you want. And getting them back together is very simple. Make sure the tape's tucked in with a good squeeze and done. That's it. This one's going to be a little more tricky. It's been 12 years since I opened one. When I was in the quad the first time, I had a Dark Side of the Moon tape that I had to do this to. This is one of the ones that, unfortunately, they're held on with a screw. So you have no choice, unfortunately, but to damage the label a little bit. To cheat, use the smallest screwdriver you can find. Like so. If I recall correctly, a good kick like that, fingers in like this. Yep. These have two little, like a locking tab on the bottom here. Now they do make these, ones with the adhesive back, and if you want to do this beforehand, this one here I had to take apart anyway because I broke at the splice and got wrapped in all the way in here. So I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just going to change the pad. These have are one solid piece, so you can cut it and then stick each one in individually. And these are made so you don't have to take the card apart. Yeah, as you can see, this one here is completely disintegrated. Oop, wrong bag. I got a little bit of a mess to clean up in this one yet, but it'll be alright. I'll put it back. I'll deal with that later on. This one here, yep, it latches in from behind actually. So you gotta get this in the groove here. Now these are only in quad carts, so these are a lot. You're not going to see these if you're doing your typical stereo tapes. Yeah, any single one of these I've ever seen was a quad cart. That was a little bit of a pain in the ass. So that just goes in like that and you pop, click it, and screw it. But I'm not going to put it back together yet because I still got to work on it. Again, Columbia. The older shells are hit or miss. Some of them have, this one here is good yet. It still has a nice spongy pad. The RCAs, okay, the best thing I can tell you about RCA tapes is get it while you're at, do it in the beginning. These use as you can see, these use the spring pads, so you shouldn't have to take these apart, but get them to the splice and do the splice right away so you'll never have to take this apart. unless it's wedding cakes on the inside, which it shouldn't, as long as you store them correctly and replace the pad. Preventative maintenance is the best on those. The GRT tapes, they have these in stereo too. So they have five tabs, one in each corner, one in the center. You're gonna take your screwdriver in, push right here, or start on this one, I guess. Sorry, there you go. One in the back. And you're probably gonna rip the label, but if you're careful enough, you can do it with minimal damage. Try to make this as easy to see as possible for you.
Am I in focus?
Yeah. Try to avoid doing that if you can, because it'll usually leave a mark. There you go, got that. Got that. And you got enough of it in there that you don't have to crack the whole thing open, because you want to try to avoid ripping a label if you can. Come on, get up. And don't tilt it over like I just did, because then the thing will fall inside the cart. That's going to be a lot harder to get out than it has to. Got it. There you go. I'm just going to kind of...
Can you see it?
Yeah, you can see it. Gonna kind of go in here like that, and push up like so, and there you go, new splice, just like that. Push down on it. It's not gonna sound good, but it's fine. Trust me. See,
all five tabs still in play intact, and you have a new foam pad installed, ready to go.
Cat Stevens tapes. These are Columbia carts too, but these must be an older one because they have the disintegrated pad. Foil splice on it's good. Now, I had a real rarity earlier today. It's actually the first time it's ever happened to me. Where's a 10 years after tape? I was trying to get that out and the piece actually broke. I've never seen that happen before. Like, I mean, the whole thing, the center, the stub and all, so. I'm gonna put my JB Weld skills to use and see if I can fix it, but I doubt it. So just be a little bit careful. Like I said, these tapes are 50 years old. A little brittle, some of them. But again, down like just like that. So these ones here, you can usually do without damaging the label. There you go. Huh? That one's got the little notch right here, so what I'll do with that is just so it sits in there good. Take a little, take the scissors and just give it a little cut right here. Snip. There you go. Now it fits in there perfectly. There you go.
Good as new.
Another Cat Stevens tape and an old... Yeah, that one there, the film is still on, but it's still done. Needs replaced.
You guys can't see that, right?
Yeah.
Good as new. That one still has a slipcase original too. John Lennon, Imagine. Okay. I actually had to repair that one early. I had a broken splice. I needed to felt that. But again, just like the GRTs. Gordon Lightfoot. These are similar to the RCA taste, but these you can actually crack. I'll show you. They're a little bit of a pain. They're real. These are especially a real stiff, but just for the hell of it, I'll show you how to crack a Warner Brothers tape. So these are pretty stiff. Get the pinch rolled apart first. There you go. Go. See that, how I did it? The center one. Center one's up. Rear one. And the other rear one. And there you go. And these are good because you hardly ever have to open these. These have the spring type pressure pads. And the full splices on these are usually pretty decent. But again, it's still better if you can get the fullest places. Play them through until it gets to the last song and change the fullest place with it out. I'm actually out of those right now. Well, I thought I had some, but I can't find them. So I'll have to order more off 8-Track Heaven or Kate's Track Shack or eBay or someplace, wherever I can get a good price on them. And these, set it down. What I do with these, I set them down like that because if you go in the corners, you can break them. Just give it one solid, all at one shot. If you look. No broken tabs, you're in business. Now, obviously, like I said before, these things are over 50 years old at this point. They're brittle, just be careful with them. These are all RCA tapes and Warner Brothers tapes, they should be good. I don't know about the Akai sampler. Yep, the Akai sampler is a, actually, it looks like an RCA tape too, but again, we're in good shape there on that. All in ready. Okay, the full splice is good. This one, I'm just going to use the adhesive one. I'm not going to do it right now because I don't want to waste you guys' time. I want to show you what you're going to use. No sense in breaking the label. I can pull the tape out like so and. Yeah, you know what? I'll show it. Why not? We're just going to kind of break it, dig the old splice out. Just be careful not to damage the tape if you can. Avoid it. Scrape as much off as you can to get this down to the bare plastic if possible. So just be careful of the tape. Use common sense. As I'm slamming the cartridge and probably a wedding cake in the inside. I'm telling you guys, use common sense. Now this is a pain in the ass. And it's messy. But again, I think it's a small price to pay, in my opinion, to avoid damaging the label. Especially on a tape like Dark Side of the Moon. So you want to get down to as much plastic as possible with a new splice, or a new splice, a new pressure pad will adhere to it. Otherwise, you're wasting your time. Okay, so you're going to cut this one, the one for the track change, pretty small. And this one fit in? I have to cut that one off a little bit too. You have a little bit of waste, but you can use that on one of the Columbia cassettes. That's what I do. I save them and use these for the old Columbia cassettes that have the pressure pad too. And put them in that. I don't have to waste anything if I can avoid it. I'm just gonna try to scrape as much out of here as possible. It actually came out pretty easily, believe it or not. So I'll put this. This is the part that's a little bit of a pain in the ass. You do not want it to hit the tape. Trying to get it, I'm trying not to block the camera because I want you guys to be able to see what I'm doing here too. Oh yeah, there you go. See, that's pretty centered, which is what you want. This song is like the redheaded stepchild of the early Aerosmith. The quad mix sounds pretty cool though, so I will at least give it that. And I'm probably never going to listen to this, but I will check it out for shits and giggles. Who knows? I might like it. So again, we're going to pull the tape out of the way. Be careful with it. You don't want to wrinkle it up too bad. But again, we're doing it to splice here, so it's going to be a quiet passage at least. Shouldn't be damaging any music if it had anything. So that's another good plus about doing it at the splice. This tape does have the original splice. And I am a firm believer in not fixing what ain't broken. The splice on it looks perfect. It's strong. I pulled on it. I made sure it's not peeling at either end. It's good to go. Come on, don't be a pain in the ass. Get it centered and push on as hard as you can. And Helen Reddy has a new pressure pad. Didn't have to take it apart, didn't have to damage the label. Still in mint condition, and now it's restored and perfectly playable. And wash your hands before handling the tape. If you touch a tape and you see your fingerprint on there, no good. Try to avoid touching the tape, period. I mean, sometimes you don't really have much of a choice. Dark Side of the Moon's already been taken apart, but not by me. It was like that when I got it. Pressure pad and it's good. That's actually a Columbia pressure pad. You can tell because it's really light colored. But someone actually probably stole that off probably a stereo 8 tape and put it in that. John Denver, that's going to be an RCA tape, see? These spring-loaded ones. Oh, that's cool. Somebody else replaced that. That's a pure white one. I have never seen that before. Wish I would have put the flash on before I recorded this video. Hopefully you guys can see it. Another GRT cart. Probably do it to the other side. I hope I don't stab myself in the hand in the process. I'm just trying to do this so you guys can see a little bit better what the hell I'm trying to accomplish here. Careful of the end label. This one here, I usually try not to take them out because I don't want to rip the label. So I put my fingers in here like that and get it open as far as I can. And just pop the old one out. Like so. And grab the new one. Oop, that piece is still in there, gotta get that out. Don't want that to get wrapped in the tape. Come on, you bitch. So slide that right in there like so. Like I said, and the reason I'm doing it this way is so I don't break the end label. Because not only does it make the label look bad, it also degrades the quality of the tape and also degrades the resale value a little bit. Before you clamp it, make sure the tape's in the groove. Come on. Takes a lot of patience. If you're in a hurry, don't bother doing it. There we go, I think we got it. We good? Yeah, we're good. And just give it a quick firm. So the tape's in, oh, we're out of the groove again. All right, we're good now. Tape's down, give it a good firm. See, all the tabs are there, nothing's broken, we're good. BTO, these ones are already replaced. That looks like that, oh, that's not the original splice. Somebody changed that already, good, I like that. They broke the, they also managed to break the tabs on it too. They probably pulled it apart with a screwdriver and pried it. Yeah, it looks like it's chipped right there. Both BTOs are like that, actually. This one does not have a replaced pressure patch. We're gonna be really careful with this because this is the only thing, only one holding it together right now. This is one of my favorite Aerosmith songs ever off any of their albums. So freaking good. That one's also got the little notch there where you wanna cut around. So give it a quick halfway up. I said the Columbia carts are by far the easiest ones to work on and by far the best design. I really hope this don't break. Yeah, we're good. Alright, cool. That's a shame. But I hate when that happens. Case. Okay, that one's already been replaced. Band on the run. Alright, yeah, we definitely don't want to damage that label. So we're going to do the same thing we did to Helen Reddy. This one here dry rotted completely off, so we should be good on that. This Aerosmith tape actually legitimately sounds good. Like, this is honestly gonna be my freaking go-to choice when I demo my quad system. There is nothing embarrassing about the sound quality of this tape right now. That in there, get it in there good. Alright, so the track change side is done. So hopefully this is a help to somebody at least. I don't feel like I'm doing it for my, making this video for my health. That'd be the hardest. I'm getting pretty good at dropping these in dead center. I've been doing this for a long time though too. Not as long as some of the trackers from back in the day though. Don't take that comment the wrong way. I'm not claiming I know more than you do, don't worry. But again, there you go. So now you have Paul McCartney and Wings Band on the Run. Fully restored, ready to go. Doobie Brothers, Captain and Me. Splice looks good. Foam pads, felt pads, tip pads are good. Moody Blues, Days of Future Past. Before I play that, I need to change the foil splice, but I actually don't have any right now. I can rig some up with some tape and aluminum foil like I used to, but I'd rather just do it the right way. Now see, this, in order to crack this one, you're gonna have to damage a label. Now I don't have to do that because I have the splice right here. See what I mean? Makes it so much easier. Felt pads are in good shape. All I gotta do is put a new splice on it. She's ready to go for another 50 years. And it's just not worth, to me, it's not worth rigging it up. I'd rather just fix it right and be done with it to avoid damage to the name label. This is another one of my favorite Aerosmith songs as well. Death Row Tall Aqualung. This one's done, ready to go. This Guess Who tape does need the felt pads replaced, but again, you don't have to crack it to do that. The splice is already good. I played this one already and played this loop on. Sounds great too. The RCA tapes sound wonderful. The only ones that sound even close to as good as that are the Columbia ones. Rock and Roll Sampler. Pads are good on that. Splice is good. Best of the Doors, we already looked at that. Best of Red, we looked at that one first. I didn't bother putting it back together yet because I gotta fix the tape and I need a full splice to do it. So unfortunately, that's gonna sit for a few days until I get some parts in. Ovation Sound Effects, again, they use the spring pad. These are Ampex carts, yellow Ampex. They're very reliable too. The full splices on these usually don't break, but I will get them through the end of it and I will check them before I go too far. But these are probably gonna be fine. These are very reliable tapes. Deep Purple Machine Head, Warner Brothers cut, which are actually pretty much the same as the Ampex. But again, these are usually relatively reliable. Foam pad, plastic wheel, they're good. Thank God I've never seen any of the quad carts on the old Learjet that had the problem with the melted pinch roller. That seems to be a stereo 8 thing of the early to mid 60s, maybe late 60s, but that predates quad anyway, so you won't even see those on the quad tapes. This is a rough condition copy of Days of Futures Past, but at least I can play that until I get full of splice, because this is one of my favorite quad mixes. I absolutely love it. Tape's worn in pretty good though. It doesn't have as good a highs as the Columbia's and the RCA as well. This is a sealed copy of Road Food by the Guess Who. I'm going to keep it sealed. Most of the Guess Who albums actually sell for relatively cheap, so I can probably get a used copy for 15 to 20 bucks and still preserve the sealed one. I just got done fixing that one a little bit ago too. But yeah, that's all we got for now. If you guys want me to do another video of this, I can show you some of the stereo ones, like the some of the other ones, like the Death Row Tall tapes, these ones here. That's actually an RCA tape, even though it's on A&M Records. It's an RCA shell. These are complete fish. You do not want to mess with these. That's why you service them. Check the splice, make sure the pads are good. Well, these use spring-loaded ones. Check the splice, and you'll never have a problem with it. This is a Columbia cart. Sorry about that, I was trying to zoom, I hit the wrong thing. I'll have to practice these are Warner Brothers carts too. I'll have to practice some of these are the later Warner Brothers carts. I'll have to practice these. These are relatively difficult, but once you master them, if I remember correctly, they're actually pretty easy to crack. But they're very intimidating at first. But that's all I got for now. I hate to freaking edit this in just for a minute long clip, but I'm not going to be happy unless my video has everything I want to cover in it, because I don't really want to half-ass it. If I got something to say, I will find a way to edit it in. I'd rather just do it right instead of have regrets later. So yeah, that being said, look at that stack. And that one. And that tape machine, though. Yeah. So that's all I got for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think, and hopefully this is helpful to some people who may not know how to crack these up. That being said, peace out, rock on, catch you next time.